Welcome back. Prime Minister Manmohan Singh invited Myanmar's opposition leader and Nobel Peace Prize winner Aung San Suu Kyi to New Delhi, even as the iconic pro-democracy leader called for better ties between the two neighbors. Earlier in the day, Singh met Suu Kyi in the commercial capital of Yangon on the second day of his landmark visit. During the meeting, Singh is believed to have handed over a letter to Suu Kyi on behalf of India's ruling Congress Party President Sonia Gandhi, inviting her to deliver a lecture in New Delhi.
We in India are very proud of our long-standing association with her and members of her family, including her parents. I sincerely hope that she will find it possible to visit India soon, and in this context, I have handed over to her a invitation letter to deliver the next Jawaharlal Nehru Memorial Lecture. Madam Da Aung San Suu Kyi's life and her struggle, her determination have inspired millions of people all over the world. Our sincere belief is that in the process of national reconciliation, which has been launched by President Thein Sein, Madam Suu Kyi will play a defining role.
I am very gratified by the invitation to deliver the Jawaharlal Nehru Memorial Lecture, and I hope that I will be able to take up this invitation before too long. And more than that, I hope that there will be greater exchanges between our two peoples. As I said to the Prime Minister, true friendship between the countries can be based only on friendship between our peoples. And this is what I hope we will be able to achieve.
The Mumbai Sessions Court has granted bail to 7 accused in the Adarsh Society scam, suspended Maharashtra Finance Secretary Pradeep Vyas, P.V. Deshmukh, retired Brigadier M.M. Vanchu, former Defence Estates Officer R.C. Thakur, retired Major General A.R. Kumar, retired Major General T.K. Kaul, and former Congress MLC K.L. Gidwani. The 7 accused have to pay a surety of 5 lakh rupees each and submit their passports. They also have to be present before the CBI twice a week. The 7 accused had filed bail applications saying that the CBI failed to file the charge sheet within the stipulated period of 60 days from their date of arrest. Acting on the Supreme Court's directive, veteran Congress leader N.D. Tiwari today gave his blood sample in connection with a paternity suit filed by a 32-year-old man claiming to be his biological son. Tiwari gave his blood sample in front of the district judge Raj Krishna, chief medical superintendent of Government Dune Hospital, B.C. Patak, Rohit Shekhar, who has filed the paternity suit, and his mother, Ujwala Sharma. The Supreme Court had on May 24th rejected 88-year-old Tiwari's plea that he was too old to give his blood sample. The court had yesterday also turned down his plea seeking to maintain confidentiality of the court proceedings in the paternity suit.
This process took 4 hours. Mr. Tiwari has given his blood samples because the Honorable Supreme Court and the High Court, he forced them to say that otherwise he would have been arrested and force would have been applied. वहाँ वो एक घंटा डेढ़ घंटा हम लोग आमने सामने बैठे और उन्होंने हमें पानी पूछा. हमने कहा, उन्होंने कहा कि भाई तुम्हारी पढ़ाई लिखाई कैसी चलती रही. हमने कहा आपकी सब कृपा है आपकी और मैं तो जानता हूँ सब शांति सद्बुद्धि रहे. उनको भी भगवान सद्बुद्धि दे, लंबी उम्र दे. लेकिन जो कानूनन प्रक्रिया है वो चलेगी और इसके नतीजे गंभीर होंगे.
Education Minister Kapil Sibal has asserted that the government's proposed common entrance test for engineering courses from 2013 is a progressive step so as to lend substantial advantage for the 12th standard results at the high school stage. He hailed the significant concept of One Nation, One Test mooted by the Congress party-led federal government. He also mentioned that there has been a dearth of qualified teachers, leaving an adverse impact on the education of the children. While the NITs and the IITs will implement the process from 2012, the IITs will initially select the top 50,000 students for their advanced tests, making a transition to the full process by 2015.
It was a unanimous decision, because for the first time in our history, the IIT Council, the IIITs, as well as the NITs, as councils sat together and unanimously decided that this must be done. The purpose of it is that school boards and school examinations are not being given enough importance by children. Previously, they were not being given importance. Now, the NIT system and the other centrally funded technical institutions will give admission on a common merit list based on 40% weightage from the board exam, 30% from the main exam, and 30% of the advanced exam. And universities and institutions can decide on the manner in which they want.
Moving on, the Indian rupee recovered marginally off the day's low of 55.65 in comparison to the dollar in afternoon trade today. It retraced gains from the past 3 days to open lower as weaknesses in the euro continue to fuel worries over the outlook for the eurozone. At 1:08 p.m., the rupee was down 26 paise from Monday's close of 55.18 per dollar. The rupee had closed higher, supported by a stronger euro as global risk assets stabilized. Indian equity markets opened higher today, but it failed to improve rupee trade. However, it is expected to prevent a sharp fall in the rupee. While a Bharat Bandh has been called for on the 31st by the opposition, the Tamil Nadu Traders Association has also extended its full support now. The association's president, T. Vellayan, announced that around 60 lakh traders across the state will take part, extending support to the strike. They also sought the support of the public to strike on the 31st. He also added that on Tobacco Prevention Day, which falls on the 30th, the traders will shun the sale of all the tobacco products. The Tamil Nadu fishermen are all set to venture into the seas for fishing as the annual 45-day ban on fishing comes to an end today. This ban on fishing using mechanized boats was implemented on April 15, as this period is the copulation season for the fishes. The fishermen utilize this time for repairing and remodeling of their boats and for upgrading their nets. However, these fishermen hope that the occupation to begin tomorrow again is not deterred by the Lankan Navy like in the past. Students from Tirupur have come up with a novel way of protesting against the hazards of plastics and its ill effects on people. 12 students skated their way from Tirupur to Coimbatore. A private skating company had organized this skateathon that was kick-started at the Tirupur Collectorate and concluded in the Coimbatore Collectorate.
Masukattupattu Variyam matrum Nimble Foot Skating Club sambandhamaga indha vilippunarvai சம்பந்தமாக மாணவர்களுடன் சேர்ந்து ஏற்படுத்தியிருக்கின்றார்கள். இதுபோல பிளாஸ்டிக் சம்பந்தமாக பொதுமக்களிடையே விழிப்புணர்வு அதிகம் வர வேண்டும். அப்பொழுதுதான் அரசாங்கத்தில் ஏற்கனவே விதிகள் இருந்தாலும் பொதுமக்களுடைய விழிப்புணர்ச்சி தான் மிக முக்கியமானது. ஆகவே இந்த முயற்சியை நான் பெரிதும் பாராட்டுகிறேன் என்று தெரிவித்துள்ளேன்.
Another short break now. Stay with us.